have APOC and Crazy Mage actually played together that you can play?
I don't know.
Because didn't they play together in the first one, and it was a little rocky?
I mean, I'm not saying it's a perfect situation, but I'm just going to point out that Crazy Mage does only have 3 goals and 7 assists, and APOC is rocking 10 goals, 2 assists.
That's true.
I think it's there's potential.
But okay.
I do think that the whole team dynamic of Crazy Mage and Apocalypse is good.
Well, and this is what I mean. I like APOC, Crazy Mage, really great players. Hootie, I haven't really seen all that much of just yet. So it's really hard for me to make a comment there, but I know Static and Restoring Hope have played to the top together before, and Moffat is a excellent team player. And I think having those two, I'm like, right now, I am sure Restoring Hope is like screaming and excited and like really getting the team hyped up, and everybody's working together, and teamwork will 100% beat this. I mean, look at that. Restoring Hope with the, well, not, I guess Static with the demo there, clearing it right out from in front of their goal. Like,
I that was a great play early on by Victoria's Secret.
Yeah.
I think that they did a good job. I think we just need to see Crazy Mage and Apocalypse get in tune together. Yeah. I'm not saying they're going to win the game. I'm saying if they can get into they would be really, really good.
Yeah. But I mean, right now you have potentially 2 players working really well together versus 3 players working really well together.
Right. I completely agree. That's a great way to put it.
Yeah. I'm just saying, like, right there, Moffat and Static had their back. Restoring Hope, if she hadn't whiffed on that, would have had that. That would have been fantastic. And even then, when she whiffed, Moffat was right back there to make sure that that was getting cleared back in to the boosted potato zone.
And there were multiple times in those scrimmages where Crazy Mage would go, I didn't expect Restoring Hope to get to that ball.
Yeah.
And it's not like her
like that all last season. It was
amazing.
And
it happens a lot. She's way better than people give her credit for.
Yeah.
Oh, but a big miss in Apocalypse.
Absolutely a ninja.
Doesn't finish it off the crossbar. So Apox probably should have had the first save on the goal that Victoria's Secret scored. I'm just going to kind of skim over that because we were talking about the dynamic of the teams.
Right.
He did miss, and that came back to haunt him as Static finished it. But right there, a big chance for a goal. He didn't finish it. I think Apocalypse really is going to need to step up. He hasn't been playing phenomenally so far in these first 2 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
And they're down 1-0 as a result. But again, it's all about consistency over these full games.
Now,
Victoria's Secret has it.
Victoria's Secret, I think, is going to keep doing a great job in this first game. And I think probably Apocalypse, Crazy Mage, and Hootie are going to kind of fumble a little bit here for the rest of this game, trying to get back into sort of a good... Oh my goodness, that bounce off that crossbar!
I didn't see it. I did not see it. I was checking stats.
Oh, watch this, watch this.
Oh, the dribble!
It doesn't even look like it's going to happen! And then it's just like, boop, nope!
That was dirty. Moffat rocking the hot shot for tonight.
That was gross. That was amazing. I loved it.
Doing it with the hot shot to him, honestly, even that much made it that much dirtier.
Didn't Fred get timed out earlier for the hot shot? What is up with the hot shot? I don't understand.
The hot shot's just supposed to be really bad as a car,
and so
it was like, you just don't say that somebody uses the hot shot, man. That's just roofed. and he scores again.
Oh my goodness!
Hot shot, new meta. Oh, all 3 players going for the save there. Crazy Mage just clears it out right to the front. Moffat makes him pay as he just drops it right into the goal. And a 3-0 lead for Victoria's Secret. That's good news.
I'm telling you, it's teamwork. Teamwork will win it. Good rotation, good support. And you can't be everywhere at once.
APOC, can I finish? No, Moffat, what a save. Oh, my goodness. I think Boosted Potatoes is feeling the pressure right now. They are going to have to respond and respond quickly. Oh, what a pass for Restoring Hope!
Woo!
Static there. That was just an... touch was perfect!
That was beautiful. I wish I could make touches that good. That was fantastic.
That was. I thought you were going to go with the classic, I wish I could touch balls like that, but... You disappointed me, Sarah. You're out of the casting game for 3 matches, and you don't, and you just start dropping the ball like that? Come on.
Oh my goodness. I'm sorry. I'll have to touch base with Restoring Hope, the married woman, for pointers on how to actually touch balls.
God. Well, down 4-0. Only 90 seconds left. Again, just like in the Smoke and Axles game, you're looking for momentum. Yeah. Anything to get the ball rolling, anything that kind of just indicates you can do something.
You know what's really weird about this game, though? This is the most I've seen Crazy Mage and Apoc whiff, like, ever. What is happening with these guys? Like,
I don't think they're too confident in each other. I think they're kind of just struggling with the idea of, is he getting this or am I getting this? It's just, and then Hootie just adds another level of uncertainty to whose ball is it anyway? And it's just like, I will point out, Mary does not equal ball touching.
Sorry to hear that, buddy.
Yeah, that's rough.
Pressing F for paying respects.
F for Rabble.
Almost gets banned.
Not able to finish that.
You know what, buddy? He doesn't really need to at this point.
Yeah, it's 4-0 with 30 seconds left. He's set nice for this game.
And Moffat with almost a double bicycle. Or a tricycle? No.
He needs one assist bicycle? To get the double cycle. Yeah, the bicycle is when two players get it. But
Yes, okay.
Oh, restore hope across to Static. Static, not going to pass him out. Good look to shoot. Goes off the post. Pitches it out.
Ah! Oh my goodness. Oh. That was a lot of action in front of that net.
Yeah, that was actually a lot of it. I mean, man, this Booster Builders team, they have to respond somehow. And Victoria Secret dominated the whole game.
Are you noticing the wonderful team colors? That was gorgeous.
I did not notice that there were dedicated colors.
Oh, yeah. That was some beautiful red.
Some beautiful red. Well said. Yeah, three times the shots for Victoria's Secret, though.
It was very Canadian red. I'm just going to put it out there.
Canadian red. Nine shots to three for Victoria's Secret. Apocalypse asking for a new server, I believe. So, are we going to... sure. Ping specs, everybody?
Yep.
Crazy Mage asking as well? Okay, perfect. We will respect that. Get a new server. In the meantime, not a lot to be said about that game. You kind of covered it very well, Sarah.
Woo! I said a thing.
You said a thing and it was correct, unsurprisingly. Yeah, no, they really just... That team dynamic coming in. The three being greater than the two.
Yeah.
All that good stuff. I mean, I don't know what really needs to happen here for Booster Potatoes to start winning. It's almost a mystery.
Maybe they, just better ping.
Better
maybe
ping.
They'll get a better ping server here and suddenly they'll be just flying all over the place.
We can only hope.
So what do you think? And what do you think? We're going to see the same thing for game two? Or do you think we're actually going to see a little bit different?
I don't like making predictions much anymore, mostly because they're always wrong.
All right, so go with your gut instinct and then say the opposite.
Okay, so I'm going to just say what my gut, which is I think we'll see Booster Potatoes respond relatively well, but they'll still lose. So I think it would be like a 3-2 loss, Victoria's Secret winning. But because that's what my gut instinct says, I think it's going to be like 5-0 Victoria's Secret takes in two games.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness.
That's what my prediction is.
So I'm going to say, unfortunately, I'm going to say that, Victoria's Secret takes the second one.
Yeah. They played really well together.
Boosted Potatoes will actually get a goal or two, though. That's the thing.
I sure hope so.
I think if we see some better ping for both sides here, that's I think Apoc and Crazy Mage will probably... I mean, you can see them sort of try to go up a little bit more. But there definitely was some whiffs, and I think that both of them have a little bit... What's the word I'm looking for here? I don't think they're really going to let that stand, kind of thing. I think at this point... If they're not quite sure, that they might just kind of say, well, screw it. I'm going to go for it then. So, and I think we've seen that before where I think Apoc went a little bit harder and Crazy Mage ducked back a little bit, which kind of explains some of the stats that we're seeing for Crazy Mage. And I think if that happens again, we're definitely going to see at least some more points go up on the board.
That's fair. I think you've got a good point there, Sarah. I do. I really just... I hate to make any predictions because I'm always wrong.
He already did, man. It's too late.
I'm just going to let you predict it, and I'm going to see what happens. Because you've been so on point. Well, I mean, we have to point out that it is also on Wasteland, because that's where both these teams are playing tonight. As a double bump comes out on the faceoff, both players bumping their own teammates. It pops in front of Static. He's going to clear it out. As Apocalypse Challenge is going to bounce into the corner. He reads his own bounce, puts a shot on goal. Strong able to clear it out.
Nope, Crazy was headed back to the goal. We haven't seen a lot out of Hoodie so far. I keep kind of waiting to see him pop up, but I feel like he's really sitting back in the crease.
Yeah, he's playing very defensively. I think he's just, it's hard to be confident when he tends to miss some balls. It's like we said, there's only so much you can do.
Yep.
The new player.
Yeah. And if Hootie's quite new, that's a really good place to get him to kind of be able to watch how the rest of the game works. And I think Restoring Hope started out pretty new to the game. I think as Hootie gets along here, he'll get a lot more experience. Hopefully a lot
more. Oh, that touched by Apocalypse!
Oh! He raids his own bounce off the wall. Apoc pushing it forward.
Saw us the whole way, and just that angle, he actually makes, I believe Restoring Hope there, flip to the wrong side. And that's just a great shot. And that's more goals than they had all of last game. That's their first lead of the series.
Mm-hmm.
And something that could be huge for Boosted Potatoes going forward.
They were a little bit of confidence?
Yeah.
Yeah.
The lead just changes so much.
Yep. See, and now that situation is exactly where they would need a stronger third player at the moment. You know, we saw Apoc and Crazy Mage bounce it out and kind of center it. But both of them were turned the wrong direction. You need somebody who's back on the midline at that point, rotated in the right spot, kind of thing. You know what I mean? Like,
somebody who could just come in and finish the shot. But it's hard to really, you know.
Oh man,
just with
I'm about to start
experience.
Calling Hootie Merlin.
Merlin? Oh no, don't.
Oh
not
no,
like this. Merlin. Hootie deserves better than Merlin.
But he was hugging. He was hugging the goalpost.
No. Until he starts humping the goalpost, there is no such.
There
Merlin.
Is no Merlin. Okay. I'm just saying, I liked Merlin, and I would love to see Merlin come back. And if we have Merlin living on in Hootie, even a little bit, I'm happy.
in the words of Rabble Rouser, a grand champion enters through the door. He fast arrows and dunks the chandelier on your party.
What?
We got into D&D recently. They took to roll. They took to putting Rocket League in it.
Oh no!
Hootie, actually,
huge
save. I'm gonna Restoring Hope.
I hope he is cheering right now because that was well deserved.
Yeah, and he keeps his team up 1-0 as Restoring Hope demos Apoc. Absolutely savage. Apoc says himself savage. Oh, he took the words out of my mouth.
See, I'm telling you, Sneaky Ninja, you can't just label
Deadly.
Restoring Hope as anything. She just
Deadly.
She just kind of fills little niches where they're needed, and you never know what that niche is. She just kind of teleports there and does it.
You know Rob loved that.
Somebody threw out a exclamation point bracket.
Oh,
for a bracket
no!
that does not exist.
Oh, goodness. Moffat, without that boot, that would have been in.
Oh, and Apocalypse demoed by Moffat as he tries to put the shot on. It goes just wide, and Static able to clear it out. Apocalypse back in after respawning. Moffat denies him, clears it out to the middle. Crazy Mage sends it back in.
These demos are so amazing right now because if you have two players being strong, taking one out gives you all the more chances right now. Although, seriously, if they want to win this one, they're going to have to start throwing some goals.
And this is a beautiful shot by Apocalypse.
Yeah.
And by beautiful, I mean absolutely lucky. Absolutely insane bounces. He gets there off the... Hits it into Restoring Hope, who's coming out to make the save. Back into his car. Into Static's car, which goes into the net. And they say the two-goal lead is the worst lead in sports. But, I mean, given how close this game has been, I'd say you'd rather have the two-goal lead than the one-goal lead. Mm-hmm. It's been a very, very close game, but the defense has been strong by Boosted Potatoes, and they've needed it. And I think game three, assuming that Boosted Potatoes did a... Game three, assuming Boosted Potatoes is able to hold on to this lead, will go to whichever team is able to score first.
I think that's a good fair call, actually. Oh, Static. Oh, and they couldn't quite get there quite in time.
Yeah. Oh, Crazy Mage going to put it on goal. Moffat makes the save. And Moffat was giving Crazy Mage fits earlier.
Look at this! You see this gameplay! The freaking Boosted Potatoes are coming back with the actual team plays here.
Yeah, they have been getting better ball control,
yep.
More aggressive play. They've done everything they needed to do to change from games 1 to 2 to kind of take that game that was 5-0 and turn it in their favor.
Yep. Even Hootie pulling through with a big save. That is team play. You need that.
Yeah, and a lot less shots this game for Victoria's Secret. They had 9 in game 1. They only have 3. Boosted Potatoes with 5, and this is a win now for Boosted Potatoes. Just ball up in the air until it hits the ground. It will be 2-0. Boosted Potatoes taking game 2, forcing game 3.
I feel very much like Victoria's Secret here this last game was not expecting them to get their stuff together on the Boosted Potatoes side, and they were kind of tossed back a little bit about that. But I don't think they're going to do that for 2 games. I think right now they're probably getting the Restoring Hope pep talk. Mm-hmm. And, they're ready to push forward and actually ready to start making some changes. And I think game 3 is going to be a lot different. We're going to actually see a more organized Boosted Potatoes, and we're going to see a bit more aggressive Victoria's Secret. I think having a lot more demos this second game was a great response to Boosted Potatoes starting to get more comfortable back into the game. So we'll see what they come up with.
Yeah, I think, again, I stand by my statement of whichever team scores probably win this game and therefore the series. But I'm interested to see how Victoria's Secret strategy changes. I mean, you can't help but feel like APOC kind of just took over that game and Crazy Mages aided in that defense. They just were able to sustain so much more offensive pressure. I think they just need to really...
Especially near the end there, I know APOC really pushed it forward, but I think that Crazy Mage followed really well.
Yeah, that's totally
true. By the end of it, we had both Crazy Mage and Apocalypse actually really kind of working better together, and Hootie being a bit more confident actually sticking in goal. So
I'm going to interrupt for a second and give an update on our non-streamed match. In game 1, Sorry took that over team 2 5-2, and in game 2, team 2 pulled that out in overtime 3-2, so they are 1-1 as well going into game 3.
Oh,
nice!
That's
team 2 at 1-4, team Sorry at 4-1. Big stuff here. Team 2 looking at elimination if they do not win out, I believe. So, big games all around for team 2. Sorry looking to take advantage in the story hole! 22 seconds in.
That's what I was expecting. Look at that. Way more aggression. They are ready. They are ready to roll again. Let's see. Having APOC go head-to-head with 3 players trying to be aggressive, and Crazy Mage even trying to be aggressive against that, I don't know, man.
There's only so much you can do. There's only so much you can do.
I mean, APOC and Crazy Mage are exceptional players, but can they beat the team?
Oh,
can
he said
they beat
it.
The dream team?
Oh, Mava and Shoto both missed somebody. Please, come in. Oh, what a save. He's able to recover in time. And just like that, we had 2 great chances, 1 for each team. But Victoria's Secret capitalizing on theirs. Boosted Potatoes not able to.
They'll get another chance here.
I mean, I know they'll get another chance, but... I hold my breath. Oh, it's not that.
No, Hootie. He was there. He made the effort. There is an effort. Look at the effort. He was ready for it. He just didn't quite get the flip he wanted.
He wasn't ready.
No, he was ready for it.
He was close.
He was very close.
And this is not the spot you want to be in as Boosted Potatoes. Down 2-0, just a minute in.
That is not it, yeah.
Oh, can he, is this going in? Is it going out?
Oh, Crazy Mage, no!
And those are the chances when you're down, when you're down stuff like 2-1, when you're down stuff like, you know, any, down at any point, you have to capitalize on your chances. And missing open nets like that is going to come back to bite you so hard. It's not an easy shot. Don't get me wrong. It's not.
They bounced the ball and then Moffat away from that one.
That's solid defensive play. That's textbook right there. But you have to capitalize on your chances, and that's going to hurt them so much because every goal means so much.
Just gonna check Moffat's ping there. What the heck happened there? 132, I guess. This...
Yeah, they'll be alright. Oh, oh, big shot by Epoch!
Look at that!
Static,
what happened to Moffat a moment ago? Did he get attacked by a small dog, or somebody bring him a beer? Oh, does he have a big dog?
No, I don't know.
I'm just saying, my small dog is enough to actually throw me off for a second there. He just
miscommunication.
Woo!
Pie, boost potatoes, and restoring hope's gonna take a kickoff goal.
Oh my goodness! Unusual. And what a kickoff goal that was! That was right where it needed to be.
Yeah, actually puts it in between both defenders, right underneath the crossbar. Big, big miscommunications here on
the
side of
all three goalies.
Yeah, big miscommunications on Booster Potatoes. Just with all the power they came out with in game two, it's disappointing to see them have such inconsistency here in game three.
Mm-hmm. I agree.
Oh, clearing out to Static there.
Good challenge.
Static, yeah, he wins the 50-50. Which is the aerial. Crazy Mage, long shot. Going to be able to get a rebound off this, but Static clears it away.
Nice clear.
Hey, Apocalypse and Moffat run into each other.
From Static tonight so far. In both directions, actually. Ooh, the nice little tip, more centering. I don't think that was exactly where I was looking for it to go, though.
I mean, they got more. 2 minutes is a lot of time. You can easily put in 2 goals in 2 minutes. But with the way these teams are playing, what is going to happen? Tell me, Sarah. You are the Nostradamus. The BLS Nostradamus.
Oh, God. Doesn't
Hootie, come on. Hootie, challenge. Take the shot, Hootie.
Go, Hootie, go. No. Go, Hootie, go. Oh,
no, they
want
each other. Stash the pushes.
Hootie went for the high five.
Hootie was like, oh. Dude, I got this. Oh, Pagos tries to stuff it. Sure side, Static, enters during both there. It's going to bounce. Crazy Mage looks to get the shot off. Only 95 seconds remaining. Yeah! Pagos! Corner!
Hootie went for the high five, and that was just what they needed. So suddenly, like, Apoc just, like, rolled it down. He was like, not happening. I got the high five.
That is absolutely an incredible shot by Apoc there. And if you can't tell by us just randomly starting to scream... Oh, Crazy Mage off the kickoff. Moffat the only one back. He's in deficiency. Passes in front. Apoc puts it wide.
No, it was wide.
Man, we really should have face cams. I did like a full motion of like body swings and stuff when Apoc scored. I was like,
I almost hit my head on the desk just now. Like, that was so close.
Crazy Mage pushing it in. Moffat able to clear it out. He gets the dunk though. Slows him down. Apoc challenges with it. It's going to go on them.
I swear to God, it was that Hootie high five that suddenly now just boosted potatoes got a revitalization.
Oh, Crazy Mage panics, hits the ball. Saxon cleared out. It's going to go.
Hootie, go.
Wide. Hootie. Now we get the touch. Crazy Mage is there though. Sends it into the zone corner. Over top of Moffat. It's rolling out. Restoring it back into the boosted potato zone. Crazy Mage over Restoring Hope. Trying to clear it out. Pushes it into the Victoria's Secret zone.
Yes.
Apoc.
Nice block by Moffat.
Yeah, absolutely. Sorry. Stuffed him. No one wants to see you, Clutch. I'm sure Sarah would get 50 more viewers. Oh, totally, dude. I completely agree.
Oh, my lord. You do know if it's a face cam, there's no boobs, right? Just saying.
And a nice little touch there by Crazy Mage. Gets it out over the top. Hootie there to make the save. And only 13 seconds, 12 seconds, 11 seconds left. Boost Potatoes needs to score now. Time running out. They need something to tie this game.
Static's trying to dunk it on the ground. There he is, Static.
Yes. It's up in the air. It's up in the air. Apocalypse gets the touch. He sends it out. Crazy Mage. Underneath it. He puts the shot in short. Oh!
Let's hit my head on the desk again.
Victoria's Secret.
They are the victorious! And their secret is restoring hope!
And just like that, victorious hope. Victorious hope.
Victorious hope. That's the way.
Victoria's secret. They increase to 3-2. Boosted Potatoes drops to 1-4. And regarding whatever the result is of...
I do have an update on that. Sorry and Team 2 went scoreless into overtime, and Team 2 put off the victory.
Oh my god!
They beat Sorry, so Sorry drops to 4-2, and Team 2 goes to 2-4.
The upset!
Oh! And that'll drop Boosted Potatoes to 5th. Man, standings just absolutely just changing up so much today. It's unbelievable.